This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part two of evaluating trig functions with a calculator. In part one, we used a calculator to find the sine, cosine, and tangent of angles, either given in degrees or radians. And it was important to make sure the mode or degree key on the calculator was set to degrees or radians, depending on whether the angle we were going to enter was in degrees or radians. The same applies for the secant, the cotangent, and the cosecant. So let's do that kind of a problem now. So we're going to use a calculator to find the function value rounded to four decimal places. Secant of 25 degrees. Our angle's in degrees, so first of all we want to make sure that our calculator is in degree mode. But there is no secant function on most calculators, or any calculator I've ever seen. So we have to know that the secant is the same thing as the reciprocal of the cosine. So we know that this is really just the reciprocal of cosine, so it's 1 over the cosine of 25 degrees. And that's what you need to enter in your calculator. Now, you don't want to look up the cosine, or you don't want to just do the cosine of 25 degrees and then round it, and then do 1 divided by that, because you'll get a rounding error. You'll be off. So you want to put this all at once into your calculator. If you want, you could use parentheses, although most calculators you don't need to. You could just put like the 1 and then either the division sign, or some of the calculators have this sign, and then you should be able to just put cosine and then the 25. That's most calculators will let you just, well, they'll give the right answer from this. But if you're not sure, you can put a parentheses around this to make sure that it's going to do the cosine first. It's pretty unlikely that it would not do that if you're using a modern calculator. Okay, so then we're going to put it all in the calculator, and so go ahead and try that on your own calculator. Make sure it's in the degree mode, and my calculator comes out, when I round to four decimal places, 1.1034. All right, let's do another one. How about the cotangent of -4.3? Alright, so the first thing I need to pay attention to is whether I have this in degrees or radians. And there is no degree symbol, so this is in radians, the angle. So I want to make sure, you want to make sure you set your calculator to the radian mode first. And after you've done that, we know that cotangent, again, there shouldn't be a cotangent on your calculator. It's the same thing as 1 over the tangent of -4.3. And again, you should be able to just enter that in as it is, and then we're going to round our answer. So go ahead and try that on your calculator. And interestingly enough, just coincidentally, it starts out with -0.4375. That has nothing to do with the fact that this has a 4 and a 3, by the way. Okay? It has nothing to do with whether this was a negative. This is what the calculation is. And if you look and see where these angles are, you know, what quadrant they're in, hopefully the signs, whether it's positive or negative, should make sense to you. So let's try another one. All right, let's do the cosecant of 350 degrees. All right, first notice it, put it in degree mode. Right, because you have an angle in degrees. I didn't write that on the previous page, but you can do that. Whoops, sorry. Technical difficulty here. There we go. So there is no cosecant button on most calculators, and so I have to know that that's the reciprocal of the sine of 350 degrees. So you want to plug that in your calculator and then round it to four places after the decimal point. And let's see, I get -5.7588 when I round the answer. And of course, if you think about where this angle is, 350, it's almost all the way around, right? Oops, sorry. 363 is down here. And remember, from all students take calculus, we can know that the sign is not positive in this quadrant, so it makes sense that we do come out with a negative number for the sign. So let's just jump back here a minute. Remember, for this problem, you want to make sure that you're going to use degrees for your mode, right? But this problem, there were not degrees, make sure you set it into the radian mode. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.